up at the JSS gates to seal the Tuscan hand of nation's fate. Mind filled with demonic fervor and white man's hate. Killed them all so they could no longer mate. Except for a hazy moon dancer and held the last dead sea scroll in her hand, given to her by a river ghost to hide in a cavern. For Amish families hold the key. Hazy moon dancer gave them a copy to read. Tells of global ice melt and a great massive flood. Coming from the northern hemisphere filled with human blood. Hazy moon dancer was killed under a silent moon. Stabbed to death by a Paxton boy with a silver spoon. She was the last to die, Susquehannock genocide. Last of her tribe, complete genocide.
the weep on love that walked past me and shifted into a cannon. A cow turned into what looked like a burning man with black spots from his head to the brow. Turned into a burning man, green spotted hands. A burning man, reptilian. Chicken in her mouth, and then he looked around at me. He wore a Nazi uniform and told me that was too much over me.
Burning man.
And Adolf Hitler showed up sitting in a chair talking to my grandpa Charlie Moses. The Nazi soldier showed up with a man, threw him into the backseat of a van. The Burning Man. The Burning Man. The Burning Man. The Burning Man.
Hands. A burning man. I want to. Ooh. And red.
red sky to believe what is reported to you. Define your black is blue.
Yeah. Shall I say our staple diet at this time in our morning worship? Namely, our studies in the first epistle written by John. We are going to be pursuing the path that is laid for us through this epistle. We may leave it occasionally when the church's calendar or something else requires it, but this is going to be our staple diet for some time. And we return to it today. Now, we're going to read as the basis of our message this morning verses 3 to 6 in chapter 2. 1 John, chapter 2, verses 3 to 6. And hereby we know that we know him, if we keep his commandments. He that saith, I know him, and keepeth not his commandments, is a liar, and the truth is not in him. But whoso keepeth his word, in him verily is the love of God perfected. Hereby we know that we are in him. He that saith he abideth in him, ought himself also so to walk, even as he walked. Now you remember the main thread of the treatise thus far. Having affirmed the historical character of the Christian faith in the beginning of chapter 1, the Apostle John then went on a step to indicate that the Christian fellowship is dominated and governed and determined in its nature by the being and the character and the nature.
Our dreams through the edge of life is tale of where we were. A story unfolds through the eyes of philosopher. Our lives are recorded like sound upon a tape, operated by a computer in this heavenly state.
Show the hour. Here they come, the Anarchy.
they continue to profess that. And the second statement is this. They apparently continue to claim to abide in Christ. Look at verse 6. He who serveth, says John, he abides in him. Ought to walk in the same way in which he walked. Now obviously we have the same kind of thing. The heretics are saying, you see, now we've left the community, we've left the church. But we still know God, and we're still abiding in the Lord Jesus Christ. This shows how influenced they've been by Christian teaching, because it's all reminiscent of the allegory of John 15, the vine and the branches. Now, to abide in Christ involves two things. First of all, it involves that a man is in Christ. You've got to be in him before you can abide in him. Mother in Christ. The Bible doesn't really divide people into cultured and illiterate. Doesn't divide people into rich and poor. Doesn't divide people into black and white. The Bible treats all these as incidental and trivial, comparatively speaking. But the great division in the Bible is this. Are you in Adam or are you in Christ? Have you been born once or have you been born again? A Christian is a man who's been excised from the Adamic stock and incorporated into the stock of the second and the last Adam. In other words, in the language of John 15, he is a man in Christ, or a woman in Christ. Incorporated into Christ, into one union, like the branch receiving a new life. That's the message. A communion means this. To use me, to pursue this analogy of vine and the branches, the vine and the branches will be said to have communion, the one with the other. In so much, the same stem of the vine. Continue to claim to abide in. I found this at one and the same time one of the most sweet and one of the most.
They apparently continue to claim to abide in.
Apparently continue to claim to abide in Christ. Look at verse 6. He who says, says John, he abides in him, ought to walk in the same way in which he walked. Now obviously.